Hi guys! Our topic for today is post-closing trial balance. Bago tayo mag-proceed sa preparation of post-closing trial balance, i-discuss muna natin what is post-closing trial balance. It is a trial balance after all nominal balances has been closed. It only includes real accounts such as adjusted assets, liabilities, and owner's equity account. Ang purpose niya daw is, it is used to verify the total debit balance is equal to the total credit balance. So, ginagawa ang post-closing trial balance after mong gumawa ng closing entries, after mong ma-close na lahat ng nominal balances. So, include lang dito ay ang mga permanent accounts or the real accounts na na-adjust na, such as assets, liabilities, and owner's equity. The purpose of this is to verify kung balance pa rin ba yung debit mo kay credit balance, kung equal pa rin ba sila. Okay? Now, let's proceed with the post-closing trial balance preparation. Again, ang gagamitin nating adjusted trial balance, our company is si Gonzaga Company pa rin. Itong adjusted trial balance ay kinuha ko lang sa worksheet na ginawa natin previously from the other videos. And then, in-extract ko lang yung accounts and their corresponding debit and credit balances. Okay? Now, let's proceed. For the heading, of course, for the first line, the company's name, which is the Gonzaga Company. For the second line, kung ano yung ginagawa natin, this time around, what we're preparing is post-closing trial balance. Then, period niya is same pa rin naman for the year ended December 31 kung anong specific year. Then now, on the first column, there will be three columns. The first column is for the accounts. Then, second column is for the debit. And lastly, for the third column is for the credit. Okay. Looking at this adjusted trial balance, ang gagamitin lang daw natin ay assets, liabilities, and owner's equity. So here, kasama si cash, because this is an asset. Accounts receivable is an asset. Supply is an asset. Equipment is an asset. Sorry, prepaid insurance is an asset, equipment is an asset, accumulated depreciation ng equipment is still a contra asset, accounts payable is liability, kasama yan, unearned income is a liability, and then salaries payable is a liability, and capital is an owner's equity. So, kasama siya. Then, the drawings up to the expenses, hindi na siya kasama kasi these are the nominal accounts. So, i-highlight lang natin siya ng, palitan natin siya ng color. Gawin natin siyang red. Para alam natin na hindi siya kasama. Okay? But then, gagawan pa natin ng konting adjustments. Magkakaroon lang naman tayo ng adjustments dyan with regards with the capital. But the rest, we just copy. Again, for the accounts, let's just copy cash, debit cash of, magkano yung debit niya? 1,380,500. Tapos, debit din daw tayo ng accounts receivable for 24,000. Kinakopy ko lang guys ha, yung account titles and their corresponding balances. Kung naka-debit siya dito, ide-debit mo pa rin siya. Then, supplies, debit natin ng 800. Then, prepaid insurance, debit tayo ng how much? 40,000. Then, equipment, debit tayo ng 84,500. Accumulated depreciation ng equipment. This is a contra asset, so it is a credit of 5,000. And then, debit ng liability, accounts payable, how much? 36,000. Next, credit tayo ng unearned income. How much? 23,500. Then, credit tayo ng salaries payable. How much? 2,500. And then, Gonzaga Capital. But then, pagdating kay Gonzaga Capital, nagkaroon tayo ng changes nung nag-closing entries tayo, kung matatandaan nyo. For those na hindi pa naguguluhan bakit may closing entries, you should watch first the previous video about the closing entries para mas maintindihan nyo ang post-closing trial balance. Hindi mo magagawa si post-closing trial balance kung hindi ka gumawa ng closing entries. Okay? Okay, so paano ba gagawin si capital ng si Gonzaga Capital? So, the original capital, na magkano yan? 980,000. Bakit wala? Wait lang guys. Kaputi. Ayan. Ay, ano ba yan? Ayan. Sorry. So, si original capital natin na 980,000, mag-a-add ka dyan ng revenue. And then, total, ile-less mo naman si drawing. And then, ile-less mo si expenses. Then, you will have the new capital. Okay, lagyan natin ng corresponding amount. Ang ating revenue ay magkano? Eto, looking at this one, ang ating revenue ay 549,700. Then, ang ating drawing, looking at this one, is 20,000. And then, our expenses, itotal na lang natin, 6,000 plus 10,500 plus 6,000 plus 5,200 plus 20,000. Ang ating total expenses is 47,700. Now, i-add natin, original capital plus revenue, 1,529,700. Tapos, i-deduct natin itong dalawa, si drawing and also the expenses. Now, ang bago na nating capital na ilalagay sa post-closing trial balance is 1,462,000. Okay? Now, let's check kung balance. Total. Sum natin. Sum. From cash hanggang pababa. So the total debit is 1,529,800. Let's check kung parehas sa total credit. So our total credit is 1,529,800. So as you see here, balance siya, equal siya. So our debit is equal to our credit. Ayan, ganyan lang kadali ang post-closing trial balance. Inalis mo lang si nominal accounts, tinira mo lang si adjusted real accounts, which are the assets, the liabilities, and then the capital. That's it. Thank you.